So, you have a project on the OPZ and you want to export an audio file. There's numerous ways to do this, and we're going to show you a few methods of doing so. Let's not waste any time. If you have an audio recorder with a line level input, then you can simply record the OPZ's 1/8 inch output. We have a recorder here. We can connect a stereo 1/8 inch to 1/8 inch cable between the output of our OPZ and the line level input of our recorder. Play the project on the OPZ to get a sound level test on the recorder. Adjust the input gain on the recorder until it peaks somewhere between -12 dB and -6 dB, and make sure the signal doesn't clip. Press stop on the OPZ when the levels are set. When ready, press record on the recorder and then play the project on the OPZ. When finished, press stop on the OPZ and then stop the recording. We now have an uncompressed WAVE audio file of our project. Now, what do you do if you don't have a recorder? Well, there's a few ways to do this. You can use your computer, phone, or tablet, which you likely do have. If you have an audio interface, you could record the OPZ as we did with the audio recorder, but that may not be the best way to record to a computer. We could get a direct digital recording off the OPZ using the new USB audio feature. With firmware 1.2.5, the OPZ can now be an audio interface for a host device such as your computer. And we can record the unit over USB to capture a fixed line-level signal that is digital. Let's see how that works. For this, you'll need a computer and the supplied USB to USB cable. Connect the OPZ to the computer using USB cable. A DAW or any app that can record audio will be necessary to capture audio from the OPZ. We'll be using Ableton Live 10 on a Mac in this example. In our DAW, open Preferences and go to the Audio Settings. Select the OPZ as the input. You can leave the output as the computer or your primary audio interface. Now, create an audio track and select the OPZ as the input. Play the OPZ to test the levels. You should see the track's meters display the levels from the OPZ. We are now set up to record. Press record in the DAW, followed by play on the OPZ. When finished, press stop on the OPZ and stop the recording in the DAW. We can now trim up the recording, adjust the gain, EQ, etc. before we export this to a WAV file. We'll discuss MIDI syncing shortly, but we feel that this method without syncing MIDI is simple and works well for most situations. But wait, there's more. Let's say you want to record stems from the OPZ. You want to continue working on your project in your DAW, so you want to extract tracks from the OPZ for further control and use in your DAW. You can either record each of the 8 tracks individually for ultimate control over your mix and arrangement, or you can group similar sounds and record stems of grouped tracks for convenience. Either way, the process is similar. And here's where syncing MIDI would help us to maintain a consistent start to each of our stems. So we need to adjust the settings of the DAW to trigger the OPZ to start when the DAW starts. To do this, we go back to our preferences. This time we go to MIDI settings. The OPZ should be listed in the MIDI ports. Should see it both as an input and an output. We want the output of our DAW to sync the OPZ. So under output, turn on sync. So when we play the DAW, our OPZ should play in sync. To group our tracks in preparation for a recording, we can simply mute unwanted tracks on the OPZ. Our methodology is pretty simple. I'm going to put the kick and the bass together because I want to mix the low end separately. I'll group the snare, hi-hats, and other percussion elements together as well. And I can record the melody and the harmony together. Or in this example, some vocals will be grouped into a stem. Again, you can record each track individually for ultimate control, but we're grouping them this way so that we can have some control over our mix and we can be efficient. The process is fairly simple. Hold down the mixer button and select the tracks you want to mute outside of our predefined grouping. When ready, press record on the DAW and the OPZ should start in sync. Repeat this process for the other groupings of stems. When you're finished, you should have a set of stems for your OPZ project. Note, the OPZ will loop the pattern chain when it reaches the end, so your audio file will need to be trimmed so that your song ends instead of starts over. Pro tip, if you place a pattern that is blank or has muted notes at the beginning and end of your pattern chain, your audio file will begin and end with silence instead of repeating. This gives you a clean place to trim your file. All right, folks, we're not done yet. What about your phone? You could also get a direct digital recording directly to your phone, which may be the simplest and cheapest method we've seen so far. So let's see how that works. With an iPhone, we need an accessory to pair the OPZ as an audio interface to the phone. We'll be using the official Apple Lightning to USB camera kit with the additional Lightning connector. Also, the Lightning to USB adapter works if you want to save a few bucks. The accessory plugs into the phone, our USB cable plugs into that, then to the OPZ. On the iPhone, we can now record to any app that can record an incoming signal, which includes Apple's stock Voice Memos app. Open the app, and when ready, press record. Then press play on the OPZ. Stop the OPZ when finished, then stop the recording in Voice Memos. Note, the default codec for the Voice Memo app is compressed. If you want a lossless version of your recording, you can change that setting in the Voice Memo settings within System Preferences of the phone. You can now record a lossless version of your project. For iPads and phones with USB-C connectors, the previous example also works, but you don't need an adapter. Simply connect the OPZ to the device with the supplied USB cable, and you can now record to an appropriate app. Okay, last question. Can you export an audio file directly from the OPZ? In short, yes and no. TE has a feature in the OPZ to bounce audio into an AIFF file directly on the unit. However, the exported file is limited to 10 seconds. To do this, press and hold Project and the Record button. Up to 5 bounces will be stored in the unit. You can access the files going into content mode on the OPZ. With that, it seems like a missed opportunity to not allow the OPZ to export entire projects or pattern chains of any length to audio directly from the unit. That would be a very convenient feature, and hopefully they consider adding this functionality in a future firmware. With that, we now know how to record the OPZ to create an audio file. Please drop a comment below and give a like if you learned something from this video. We really appreciate your support in helping grow this channel. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks!